It's the first day of summer, and get ready to be amazed in a sunflower maze.
I can tell Teresa wrote that one. Teresa is live in Centerville at the fruit station there. And Sanger, how you doing this morning?
Good morning. It is so beautiful here in Sanger this morning. The sun is shining, and nothing's a summer like sunflowers. And I'm here with the owner of the Centerville Fruit Station, Michael Strombe. So good to see you.
Good morning.
It's so magical here. We have video of the sunflower maze, and this just kicked off last week, and the Central Valley is invited to come out and just walk through, and they are going to see nothing like this here in the Central Valley. It's definitely a blessing here. And tell us your experience. So in March, you had a handful of sunflower seeds, and then what happened?
Well, what happened, I was going to plant just some sunflowers just to have them for cut flowers here at the fruit station, and then I decided that, you know, I'm going to about an acre worth of ground over there, and I'm going to plant a maze. So I went out there and planted, I think, 24 different varieties of sunflowers, and there's a little winding trail where people can come take a look and walk through the sunflower maze.
And people will be amazed. Okay, I am really amazed. I think this is a miracle. Okay, so in 3 months, these sunflowers are over 20 feet tall.
Yeah, no, it's crazy. I had no idea that they'd get this big. There's some that are 25 feet tall and still have not made the flower up on top. I think that in the end, some might get over 25 feet tall, and nothing but water. Didn't give them any fertilizer at all. They just grew naturally that way.
That is something else. No fertilizer. I'm holding one right here. I'm calling it a baby. This is like 3 pounds over here, the sunflower. And you could just look at the seeds in here. And there's so much that you could do with sunflower seeds, from making sunflower seed oil, sunflower seed butter, and this is, of course, a Central Valley favorite snack.
Yeah, it really is. And they're really easy to grow. I mean, if people out in, you know, the valley want to grow them, they can just grow really easy. No problem at all.
So this idea of yours, just planting these sunflower seeds just 3 months ago, how does it feel when you are walking through that maze, just seeing this beautiful full bloom?
No, it's really cool, and it actually turned out better than I thought it would. I just hilled it up and put some plastic mulch down and drip tape, and they basically grew on their own. And I did it, you know, for a lot of people that stop at the fruit station as a photo op. People can stop and take a picture there.
Yeah, and I like it here too. We are here at the Centerville Fruit Station over here, and this is really memorable for you because you grew up over here, and this was a gas station before. It was a Shell station.
It was. You know, I farm around the corner from here, and I can remember, you know, 45 years ago with my father coming here to get gas for our tractors, and then in 2010 I converted it from a gas station to a fruit stand. So that's what we've been doing, and it's been really cool.
Well, Michael, thank you so much for the warm welcome, and thank you so much for sharing this with Central Valley. And this is the first day of summer, and sunflowers are saying it's summertime. It is so beautiful out here. Definitely come check it out here in Sanger. It's at 16155 East Kings Canyon at Centerville, and you'll see the fruit stand. And stop by and have some delicious local fruit and celebrate summer with beautiful sunflowers. And don't forget to take pictures out there. It is so magical.
All right, thank you, Teresa. It is a really cool spot. I've driven by several times. I need to stop there.
And the fruit looks amazing. The way they present everything is beautiful. Thank you, Teresa. Have fun. Don't get